Hello everyone, this is Kenny Bruni from Cambrotech and welcome back to the channel. So in this series of videos, we are learning Bootstrap 5. And in this particular video, we are going to look at Bootstrap icons. So Bootstrap uses some icons that are pretty much awesome that we need not to use other third-party libraries like Font Awesome or any other icon we can use. So over here at the very top navbar over here, you can see icons. So when you click on icons, it's going to lead you to another page and it says Bootstrap icons, and just to see it for yourself, it is free. So it says free high quality open source icon library with over 1500 icons. Includes them any way you like, so you can look at it by including it as SVG or by sprite or web fonts or with or without Bootstrap in any project. So here's the Bootstrap icons page, and first of all, we need to do an installation of it. So as you can see, we need to click on this link, install, and it's going to lead us to the very bottom over here. So Bootstrap icons are published to npm. So npm is a node package manager, but you can also, but it can also be manually downloaded if needed. Okay, so we can use npm to install the icons. We can also download this, as you can see over here, the zip file over here, but in this particular example, we are going to use the CDN. So you click on this particular link. I'll just copy this and I'll come into my HTML documents over here, and inside of the head tag, okay, inside of the head tag, I'm just going to come in here, and first of all, let me just add in a comment over here. So I'll say Bootstrap icons CDN, and just beneath this, I'll just paste the link I just copied over here. And I'll save. So this is the icon, and as you can see, it is linking me up to the Bootstrap icon. All right, and this can be used in other versions of Bootstrap as well, so it doesn't necessarily has to be the version 5.1 as we are learning. All right, so now let's come to the very bottom over here and let's see some of the interesting icons that we can use in Bootstrap. So first of all, let me just come in here and have a container div over here. Let me do a margin y of 5. All right, so far we haven't done anything too fancy yet, and let me just put this next to each other. All right, so let me open this up once again. So when I come to the very top after the installation, obviously you can see that all the icons are listed over here. Okay, if you are sure of what you are doing, you can just look at it from this end, but I mean, these are over 1000 icons and you cannot look through just like that. So there's a search bar over here which you can filter. So for instance, if you are looking for an icon like, let's say, Twitter, you can search over here, you see Twitter, okay, and you can look at, let's say, Facebook, and these are very popular icons that you can have anywhere. So as you can see, whilst I was typing Facebook, anything that is related to Facebook, okay, so this is just Facebook by name, but then as you can see, this is a Facebook Messenger icon. And this Meta, the new kid on the block, or maybe the old grandfather, now the new kid on the block. And this is Meta, and this is WhatsApp. And these are all related to Facebook once again. So as you can see, it gives you what you are searching for and anything that's related to it. Okay. I don't know why there's no Instagram. But then, yes, there's Instagram over here, but I was thinking Instagram should also be related to Facebook. Okay. And you can search for cloud or anything of that sort. So let's settle on cloud over here, and let's say you want to search for this, so you can see dot cloud arrow down. So like, let's say you are downloading something from the cloud. Okay, so I can click on this, and when I click on this, you can see that I can download the SVG. That's not what I want. I just want the font icon. Okay, so this is going to give me some HTML icon tag with this class, and this class is what I need. So I'll just copy this. I can also copy the SVG format over here, but then I want it this way, so I'll just copy this, and all I then need to do is to come in here into my container as I'm doing over here, and I can just paste it over here. So when I save this and go back to what I'm working on, you can see that I have this showing up over here. It looks pretty small. We can style things up over here, and we are going to look at it as we move along. So this is the class over here. So it says bi-cloud-arrow-down. Now let me show you one trick that I use. So let's say I have, and let me go back and go and search. So let's say I have Twitter. When I click on this and come and copy this, and let me just bring this one down over here and save. Now let me go back and go and search for Facebook, and let me just copy this and bring it down here once again, and let me copy one last one, and let me just search for, let's say, user. Okay, so the number of user icons I have over here. So let's say so let me use this person. Let me just copy this and bring this over here and save. So once again, these are all the icons I just copied. And let me put this side by side. So then what do we have over here? And let me open this up so that we see this very well. So you can see that all the icons have some level of consistency. Okay, they are all prefixed by bi dash and the name of the icon. So this bi simply means Bootstrap icon. Okay, so as you can see, we have bootstrap icon dash, and let's say Twitter, bi dash, Facebook, bi dash, person. So if your guess is as good as mine, we can do an icon, and this is actually an icon tag. Okay, and inside of this we can have a class of bi dash, and let's say we do Instagram. When I save this and I'll come back over here, you can now see the Instagram icon over here. So intuitively, you can use your own intuition to guess some of these icons, and that's why you need to use these icon tags over here. Now alternatively, remember, we could have used the HTML element over here for this SVG. Okay, so I can actually copy this, and if I come here and I can paste it over here and save this, this is also going to give me the icon. Okay, so when I open it up over here, I can see this other person over here. Okay, this is the first one, this is the second one, and as you can see, this is a path. I mean, you can't keep this in your head. Okay, and as you can see, this is a class name, bi dash person. But with this one, you can actually increase the width and the size over here. So let's say I have 160, I can have another 160 over here. And when I save this and come back here, you can see that this is now big. Okay, it doesn't matter because we can also size this up over here. But I think this, as we have over here, as opposed to this, I'll prefer this because this is pretty much short and it keeps my code very simple. So let me just get rid of this, save this, and see how, now that we want to increase the size of this person, how do we go about it? So let me just put this side by side. And what I would want to do is, I can actually put this in a span tag. Okay, so let me put this person in a span tag. Let me do a Control X and actually paste this over here. Now, nothing will change, obviously. Now, I can now start styling the span tag. So let's say I want it big. Okay, so I can do an H1. And remember the H1 typography that we spoke about. So now this is going to assume or going to take the H1 font size. Okay, I can equally do a display-3. And this is going to be a display-3. Okay, and we can go on and on. Now I can also do a txt-info. And it's going to change the color of this text. It looks pretty much awesome. Now somebody may be asking, why don't I style this in here, because there's a class over here. Now let's see. Now when I do txt-info, and let me do danger over here so that we kind of see the difference. When I do txt-danger on this, it equally works. Okay, it equally works. I can also do a display-4 over here, and this is also going to work. So it pretty much depends on what you would want to do. You can either put it in a span tag, or you can style it alongside this class element we see over here, because it can work that way. All right, so let me just continue to start Facebook. So on Facebook, let me do a font size of, let's say, 4. And when I save it, I see that this is looking good. And let me do a txt-primary. And this is looking like Facebook, actually. For Twitter, let me do a display-4 on Twitter. Okay, so this is going to be big, as you see it over here. And let me do a txt-info, because I think the Twitter is this info color. And as you can see, it looks pretty much awesome. Now, for this download or this arrow, cloud arrow I have over here, let me do a display. Once again, a display-4. And let me do a txt-secondary. And this is what we have over here. So this can be a download link. So this is just going to be an introduction to the icons over here. The rest of it depends on actually what you are doing. And you just have to come in here. First of all, click on download. Okay. And grab the CDN if you exactly want to do what I'm doing. And the next thing is to come in here and search for the fonts. And intuitively, you can actually search for any fonts that you want. So you can come in here and actually search for, let's say you want to something on statistics. Okay, so when I do stats, you don't see stats. Okay, so now let's do chat. All right, so clearly you can see that statistics didn't work for me. So now chat, and there are a number of charts over here that can be used to represent statistics. So this is going to be the end of this section. Now, if you find this tutorial very interesting, there are a couple of ways you can help me grow my channel. Kindly subscribe to Cambrotech and don't forget to hit on the notification button so that anytime I release a video, you'll be duly notified. Also, share this video with friends and family who find this content very useful. At Cambrotech, we say learn programming. You can do it. And catch you in the next video. Bye-bye.